We are back with the Boolean indexing. The last class we studied with this particular example where we tried to use our Boolean indexing properly in the indexed part. The explanation which I gave was with these two, where I was trying to tell you that you can store the index values with the true and the false sections into a storage variable. Like here, your T and F is there, and we were trying to store all the index value which is having the odd, you know, values into one, and the even values into one. That is, T is storing all the even values and F is storing all the odd values, and we print those data frame with these indexes. So we told we will be getting the output based on those values. So the output will be like this way. See, 0, 2 and 1, 3. So 0, 2 is the, you know, are the even values, and 1, 3 are your odd values. So very clearly we discussed till here. Now the same style we are trying to use with masking the data based on data values. So we will not be storing anything into any variables. We are directly trying to use the index part with the Boolean style. DF1 of lifestyle is equal to Goodman's, wherever you have a column called as lifestyle, and if the value, if the data is having this particular, you know, string called as good, that would be printed. But remember, it won't be printed as good. You see the output, how it comes. This is the output, this part, okay, where my cursor is now pointing to. Now how does output come? It's the index and true, true, false, false. Why? Because there are two different CD sections where I have given the data value as good. When you check it out with your coding, you will understand that. See, I have given for two different series good, good. Not two different series, for one, two different column values, good, good. Okay, for the lifestyle it's given good, good. So automatically the answer will be true, true, false, false. As I told earlier, that part we won't be using, but I'm just showing you. Suppose if it comes, don't think the answer will come as good, good, excellent, average. It will come based on the Boolean style. So true, true, false, false. Okay, now the next one, see, we are trying to do the same thing, but this time with the index part. Now if these things should work in this example too, if the things should work, then the index should be mentioned as 0, 1, 2, 3. That is, we are not specifying the index by ourselves, only when it will work. Otherwise it will work with our, you know, the example one's style, that is with our exclusive keywords called as these two. Our lock and I lock. Okay, so this can be used. So understand Boolean indexing properly, output question can come from there very clearly. So what is the last example we are talking about, where we are trying to put a condition? You can directly give this condition here, but I am trying to put that into a variable mask. So DF1 index equal to 1 means, if you have an index called as 1, that will be stored into mask. So if you give print df1 of mask, then the answer will be the particular record of the index 1. See, 1, 3, 4, 2, 3, 2, 6, 7, 0, 0, good. Same way, another condition with the relational operator, that is df1 dot index greater than or equal to 2. So all the index which is greater than or equal to 2 is stored into mask 2. Remember, again we can give this condition directly here. This condition can be directly given here in this square bracket in our subscript part. So then the conditions will be all those index satisfying this particular, you know, conditions where you have all the values ranging more than or equal to 2. So the answer will be 2, 3, because in our example we only have 0, 1, 2, 3. So only 2, 3 index will come and the records will come. So that is the Boolean indexing style. So with these two examples, the prioritization of Boolean indexing is over. That means how to categorize your output question based on Boolean indexing is over. These are the kind of output questions we can expect from Boolean indexing. Or in a program, you can try out with any such, you know, direct condition questions also. So try it out and let us see before the example comes or assignments comes. Now, the new section, that is selecting or accessing individual values. Selecting or accessing individual value means till now we were actually extracting a record or a column values completely. Now, suppose if I want to specifically access one value, you can say, check in our old example, all the time we were accessing records only, or we were trying to access the column values as such. Now, in this example, we are having four different methods to access individual values. The same example is taken, that is import pandas as pd. You have the series. This time the index is back. Okay. Delhi, Goa, Kerala, Punjab is back, because that is the way we can easily understand how this works. And the first is our printing of your data frame. So DF1 is printed. So the whole thing will come as output. Now, the first example of accessing the individual values. See, DF1 dot population. Now, what is population? Population is your corresponding key in your dict1, which is passed as your data frame. So when you print the output, this is how it comes. Population is your column name. Average income is your column name. Lifestyle is your column name. Correct? No? And Delhi, Goa, Kerala, Punjab is your index name. So understand this very clearly. When you try to extract a single value, individual value, we will try to give, or we have to give DF1 dot the column names. You cannot give DF1 dot the index value. Index always comes in the subscript. So DF1 dot population Delhi actually means we are trying to extract the population of Delhi. Because it is easy, because our index is self-explanatory, we are able to extract it properly. If it was a 0123 index, then instead of Delhi in quotes, we should have given 0123 as it is shown in the second example. See, even if we have given an index with Delhi, Goa, Kerala, Punjab, the second example says we can try to access it with the numerical values of index. So same thing will be displayed here with DF1 dot population of 2 means in the index 2, what is the population? So again, the output will be, the two output will be, see, population is Delhi is 1010. So that's the first one over here. And the second population index row 2. So you have 012. Delhi, Goa, Kerala. Kerala is the second row here, right? So there the population is 606062. So this is how your extraction comes in the normal manner. Now, a panda has introduced two more new function called as at. And I shouldn't say actually a function, it is an attribute. All these are attributes, okay? Function always comes in the bracket. So if I make a mistake, understand that this is it. All these which we are trying to do with the attribute, df1 dot population, df1 dot at, df1 dot iat, all these are your attributes. So pandas has introduced a new attribute called as at, where I have the privilege, or I have the option to give more than one. See, that means I don't have to give that other style of extracting it like the, you know, first two example. More than one, when I say Kerala is your index, average income is your column name. So it's like the old way of putting in a two-dimensional array the row and the column. So Kerala's average income is been represented, or it would be displayed using at. The meaning of at is exactly as it is in English. I mean, like, at means in that particular location. DF1 dot at, what you have in Kerala's average income, that will be coming as the output. And this is it. Kerala's average income is this one, no? See, it's given here. You can check with your, I mean, the original one and try the example. And the last one. See the last one? DF1 dot IA at. IA at means index at. That means these four example which is right now shown here is trying to show you that I can extract individual values using, of course, the column name without any change, that is population or whatever you have given as column name. But index can be given with the name which you have given or with the index value, that means row, mean the in numerical values of index. So either with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, or with the original index value we can extract. So the first and the third example, see what I'm saying is this one, this and this, where it is using with at and directly with your column name, is using your original index value, and the second and fourth value is using your index numerical value. So what is the meaning of df1.i at? df1's index at 3, 2. 3 is your row and 2 is your column. So find out 0, 1, 2, 3. So third one, this is it. And the column is population 0, 1, 2. So it's actually Punjab's lifestyle is checked with the last one, and the lifestyle of index row 3 is average. Check it out. Correct? Punjab's lifestyle is average, you know. See, you can check. So this is a way to extract individual value. These four methods are only available, so you can access it easily. So I am right now preparing you to do a lot of different questions with the available functions and attributes of Pandas data frame. So the first example was how to create in the first session of this. Then we learned how to access symbol functions values. Remember that size and all, and then we learned Boolean indexing, and now we are with how to extract the individual values. Let's move on. I hope you got it. If you have any doubt, you can always get back to me. Now, suppose if I wanted to change a value, already you have created a value, directly. What if I wanted to change a value? If I wanted to change the value, you can directly use the same method which we just used. That is, see, df1.at Delhi, that is your corresponding index. That is something to be kept in mind. Remember, when we use at, I didn't say that here. When we use at, we are using the index first and then the column. Clearly understand? Here also the row and the column. Okay. So don't get confused, but when we use the other method, we are using the column as the attribute and then index comes as a subscript. So don't get confused. So that same style we are using here. So when we are when you are modifying a data in a data frame, here we are using Delhi, population, where Delhi is your index, population is your column name. Both are given in quotes. You should know why we are giving in quotes, because they are the string value which we have given directly in quotes in the creation time. So we have to follow the same methodology. So I am modifying the population which I had given earlier to a new value. Similarly, I can use df1.iat also, 1, 1. I am again trying to do with the iat, that is index set, where the 1th index, 1th row, 1th columns value is changed. So which will be changed with 1th row and 1th column? So you have here 0, 1. That is your Goa. And 1th value, that is your income. Population is your 0th value. Income is your 1th value. So Goa's average income will be changed with this corresponding, isn't it? 939393 will come there only. So you can try out both. I have not given the output because this is for you to try it out. Now then you can ask the same doubt as many of you already have it. Can I use the same method which I introduced in the other one? It is df1.population. With the attribute df1.population and Delhi given as the subscript. The answer is yes, you can use it for modification, but with a warning. But it's fine, no problem. Even if the warning comes, it works. So basically, when we modify in a answer sheet, you better use your at or iat. But in a program, if you use this also, they cannot cut your marks. So directly you can modify with the same methodology how you extracted individual values. Now, since some are same, we are moving on to the last section, I hope, over here, that is adding a column. How to add a new column? Now, when you add a new column, here in these examples, it always adds at the end. There is no way of right now giving it in between. Okay? So, see how the first one comes, method one. You create a column with the, you know, see that attribute is given as the column name. DF1 bracket, I am giving common jobs. That can be given in double quotes or single quotes. So, common jobs become a new column name. And my values are given as the list. Farmer, engineer, tourist. Again, farmer is coming. So, the first example shows you have to add it with the, see, I don't know whether it is clear to you. That, you know, the size of the font, you should tell me if it is not clear. When I did with the first example, I added my new column, that is common job, with farmer, engineer, tourist, farmer as the values. So the first example is clear, so it will anyway go to the end only. Now second example, I am using with our slicing style, using the at, and at says where to put it. So right now I had put colon and I had put comma. So what is the meaning of colon? From starting from zero to the last. So after that I am adding this density. So you already have now population, average income, lifestyle, common job is also introduced, and density will come at the end. So we can explore this more and afterwards. So right now understand these two methods of adding, where the second one is using at and the first one is using directly the population, I mean not population, the common job as a column name. Here inside that index of the first example, always you should give the new column name, okay? The common job is a new column name, can be given in single quotes or double quotes, and directly you can put it into a, the values can be put it into a list. The second one also is a list of values, but the style of giving is with at. So the attribute name is at, and we are introducing with colon. Now you can give without colon also, if you try, you will get an answer, but see how it comes, okay? No, because it depends on the version. I think in mine, narrow cave, I'll check out and get back to you regarding that. So at colon means which position I wanted to input. Or you know, incorporate these two values. So that slicing colon is starting from zero to the last, and the last section density will be added. So this is how it comes. Now there is one more method of you know, assigning a new data frame, that is assign. That means what I will do is I will, along with DF1 is right now having how much? Population, average income, lifestyle, common job, density. And I am using that DF1 with a new function. Now assign is a function. And inside the assign, I am adding that new column called as capital, where I am putting Delhi, Punjab, Trivandrum, Chandigarh as a capital. And that is stored into a new data frame called as DF2. So DF2 becomes a new data frame with a new column name with the existing values of your DF1. So that is how you do your addition of a new column. So how many methods we just learned? We learned three methods. We won't go further for this session. So we are coming, trying to conclude here. So just trying to, you know, review. You had these three methods. First one is the most easy, where you directly put it into your corresponding functions, you know, not function, that index part, directly put your new column name in the index part. The second one is using an at, where you give a colon and then you give density, so it will go to the end. I'll try more example with at and let you know how it works if I can incorporate in between. When I tried, I think I had an error, so I'm not putting it again right now. And then the third example or third style was using assign, where directly we are putting it into a new data frame, where capital is your new column name and Delhi, Punjab, Trivandrum is your, Delhi, Panaji, Trivandrum and Chandigarh is your new values inside that. So what did you learn today? of course, Boolean indexing a little bit, and then we added how to add a new column name and of course modification.